Beloved, you're welcome to today's study as we continue in our intent study of the Gospel of John. And today we shall be studying the chapter 1 of the Gospel of John, and we shall focus our study on verse 43 to 51. Verse 43. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now, Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him of whom Moses wrote in the law, and also the prophet wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Jesus saw Nathanael coming towards him and said to him, "Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered him, "Before Philip called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered him, "Because I said to you, I saw you under the fig tree. Do you believe? You will see greater things than this." And he said to him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man." Beloved, this is the word of God. And you will notice that over the last few days, since when we began this study, we've been directed, as scripture has led us, to do some intent study on the person and the character of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And you will notice that in the scripture, the word of God makes us to understand the struggles, the battles that individual had in relation to the person of Jesus Christ. And Jesus, as we studied yesterday, was introduced to Peter and Andrew. And we noticed yesterday, as we did the study, that it was an encounter that transformed the life of the men who sought to see Jesus. They left everything that they were doing, and they went to be with Jesus. And today we are told that the sequence of occurrence of this matter is that the next day Jesus decided to go to Galilee. And as Jesus had decided to go to Galilee, he encountered another person whose name is Philip. And Philip said to him, and he found Philip and said to him, Jesus said to Philip, what? Follow me. And this has been the cry, this has been the statement that Jesus has made to men in even our times, in times like this. He said to him, come, follow me. And there is no critical time that this word is not so much needed to be heard by as many that are in our world today. He said, come, follow me. Now, Philip, we are told by scripture, was from the city of Bethsaida, the same city of Andrew and Peter. And you notice that these persons, Andrew and Peter, had an encounter with Jesus Christ. And this time, Philip was the one to have that encounter. And we notice that no one who had been called or has been called by Jesus and has been with Jesus remained the same. He becomes a witness. And so it is right to assume that there was a witnessing before Jesus' encounter with Philip. And Jesus said to him, follow me. And we are told that Philip also in turn found Nathanael and said to him, we have found the one whom Moses in the law and also the prophet wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph. So you see the mission angle that all humanity, those who have encountered Jesus, the mission, commission that each believer has, that we are, after having encountered the Lord, are to be missionaries, individuals, people who witness to others about their encounter with Jesus. And it beholds on us today that having had an encounter, particularly for those of us who are believers, that having had an encounter with Jesus, we ought to be witnesses of the gospel to persons around us. It comes naturally. It's a witnessing that you don't struggle because an encounter, because of the experience of an encounter. And in verse 46, we see Nathanael making a statement. A statement of pessimism. A statement of being skeptical. A statement of not being sure what to believe. And he says, can anything come, anything good come out of Nazareth? And we can even conclude that this statement is prejudicial in nature. It seemed to mean to conclude that Nazareth will not produce anything good. But God used the foolish things of this world to shame the wise. God is in the business of using the foolish things of this world in order that the wise will be shamed. And Philip gave him an appropriate answer. Come and see. Some persons will always say that the taste of the pudding is in testing it. That if you want, come and see for yourself. If you think that nothing good will ever come because you are prejudiced, come and see. Come and see and test that the Lord is good. And I want to say to us listening and watching me from the other end, come and test and see that the Lord is good. And Nathanael went. He didn't stay. He accepted the invitation. And Nathanael came to Jesus. And he immediately, Jesus saw him. He said, "Behold, an Israelite, in whom there is no deceit." And this is a commendation. And this can be seen that it can be interpreted to mean that Nathanael was a seeker. He was a seeker of the truth. He wanted to know the truth. He was someone that was a genuine seeker. His heart was plain. He was in search of the life liberating truth. And for many of us, watching, some of us are not yet seeking. Some of us are seeking, and we're seeking in the wrong places. My prayer for you is that you will seek in the right places. That you will seek in the same way that Nathanael was a seeker. And Jesus said to him, "In him there is no deceit." And this can also interpret to us that if we have a man whom Jesus says to him there is no deceit, but there is something that is missing, that man has no deceit, but is yet to have an encounter with the Lord. And we have persons who are adjudged to be good, adjudged to be plain, adjudged to be disciplined. But the critical question is, do you know the Lord? Have you had an encounter with Jesus? And that's what the Lord is calling us to do even today. And then Nathanael was stunned by the statement of Jesus. And he said, "Do you know me? How do you know me?" And Jesus said, "I saw you." And this is profound. Jesus knows. He knows the thought of your heart. He knows the thought of your mind. He says, "I saw you while you were under the tree, under the fig tree." And Jesus knows beyond what we think he knows. He knows the pain of our heart. He knows the trouble of our heart. He knows that is unsettling us. He knows. And you can be sure that because he knows, when you come to him and you are willing to listen to him, you are willing to accept his lordship, he will speak to you. And Jesus, Nathanael was stunned. And he said, "Master," he said, "you are a rabbi, you are a teacher." And that in itself, the fact that Jesus knows all things, was a revelation for Nathanael. And he couldn't conceal it. And he said, "You are a rabbi." And Jesus said to him, "Because I say to you, I saw you under the fig tree, you do believe." That's the reason you believe. You believe because I say, "I saw you under the fig tree." But listen to what Jesus now said. Jesus now said to him, and he said to him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you will see the heavens open." Now, when any man comes to Jesus, when any man is a seeker, a genuine seeker of the Lord, you can be sure that the heavens will be open unto him. Men who seek the Lord have the heavens open unto them. The heavens are open unto them, and they are soaked in the rain of godliness. They are soaked in the rain of righteousness. They are soaked in the rain of providence. They are soaked in the rain of grace and mercy. And he says, "You will see the heavens open." The Lord, coming to the Lord, enable us to see clearly and to see the heavens open. Once we drop our titles, we drop our egos, and we come to the Lord, the scales on our eyes falls off, and we are able to see the heavens open. And what is happening when the heavens open? We see the Lord walk in wonders. He says that where the angels were from heaven, were coming down from heaven, and they were ascending and descending. For us, it is a revelation that God is at work in the life of humanity. And today, the Lord is saying, come. With all your skepticism, come. Come, and the heavens will be open. You will see greater things. You will see beyond just Jesus knowing your needs and meeting your need. You will see the heavens open. You will have access to the throne of grace. You will have access to the throne of mercy. But it requires two things. Number one, receive Him. Number two, believe in His name. Thank you for joining us in today's teaching. If you have not believed in Him, you need to believe in His name. You need to receive Him. And then the heavens will be open unto you. Join us tomorrow as we continue on this series of teaching. God bless you.